open thou our lips. God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
Praise ye the Lord. The Lord is saved.
first lesson is from Isaiah. Upon your walls, O Jerusalem, I have posted sentinels. All day and all night, they shall never be silent. You who remind the Lord, take no rest and give him no rest until he establishes Jerusalem and makes it renowned throughout the earth. The Lord has sworn by his right hand and his mighty arm, I will not again give your grain to be food for your enemies, and foreigners shall not drink the wine for which you have labored. But those who garner it shall eat it and praise the Lord, and those who gather it shall drink it in my holy courts. Go through the gates. Prepare the way for the people. Build up the highway. Clear it of stones. Lift up an ensign over the peoples. The Lord has proclaimed to the ends of the earth. Say to daughter Zion, see, your salvation comes. His reward is with him and his recompense before him. They shall be called the holy people, the redeemed of the Lord, and you shall be called sought out, a city not forsaken.
My soul, and my spirit have rejoiced in God.
second lesson is from John. Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Then the Pharisees said to him, "You are testifying on your own behalf. Your testimony is not valid." Jesus answered, "Even if I testify on my own behalf, my testimony is valid, because I know where I have come from and where I am going. But you do not know where I come from or where I am going. You judge by human standards. I judge no one. Yet even if I do judge, my judgment is valid, for it is not I alone who judge, but I and the Father who sent me. In your law it is written that the testimony of two witnesses is valid. I testify on my own behalf, and the Father who sent me testifies on my behalf." Then they said to him, "Where is your Father?" Jesus answered, "You know neither me nor my Father. If you knew me, you would know my Father also."
Thank you.
us pray. Show thy mercy upon us. Ministers with righteousness. O Lord, save thy people. Give peace in our time, O Lord.
Because there is no other that findeth for us, but only thou, O God.
O God, make clean our hearts within us. God, the strength of all who put their trust in you, mercifully accept our prayers, and because in our weakness we can do nothing good without you, give us the help of your grace, that in keeping your commandments we may please you both in will and deed, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of all enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Light in our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Just a word of welcome to all who are visiting St. Paul's this evening. You may remain standing. It's going to be real quick. Special thanks to our guest singers who have traveled from afar and some near who came to our choral conference yesterday and who are singing with us tonight. Thank you. And of course, what do we say to our guest artist in residence, Catherine Deans Williams? Thank you. We see that you brought your weather with us from England. Let us also be reminded of our baptism in this weather. And we hope that you all have a safe evening and may the best team win. Let us pray.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, creator of the changes of day and night, giving rest to the weary, renewing the strength of those who are spent, bestowing upon us occasions of song in the evening. As you have protected us in the day that is past, so be with us in the coming night. Keep us from every sin, every evil, and every fear. For you are our light and salvation and the strength of our life. To you be glory for endless ages. Amen.
Amen. O God, the life of all who live, the light of the faithful, the strength of those who labor, and the repose of the dead, we thank you for the blessings of the day that has passed and humbly ask your protection through the coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning hours through him who died and rose again for us, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Lord, support us all the day long on this, our earthly pilgrimage, till shadows lengthen, evening comes, the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then in your tender mercy, O Lord, grant us a safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at the last. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and remain with you always.
Thank you.
Let us bless the Lord.